We have a real bluegrass treat for you this morning. Edward Lee was born right here in New York, in Brooklyn, but 10 years ago, he went to the Kentucky Derby and fell in love with Louisville.
He's now the chef and owner of two restaurants there, 610 Magnolia and the recently opened Milkwood. He was a fan favorite on Bravo's Top Chef Season 9, and we are delighted to welcome Chef Edward Lee to The Dish.
Thanks for having me.
Thanks for being here. And what have we got here this morning? Because it looks spectacular.
We've got a lot of bourbon, both in liquid form.
I'm so glad to hear you say
and
that.
And throughout the food as well.
The morning just got a little bit better.
Yeah,
so,
yes.
I mean, so what really happened? You grew up in Brooklyn, the child of Korean immigrants.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You head to Kentucky for the Derby. You drink a lot of bourbon, and you decide to stay?
I drank a little too much bourbon.
Yeah.
And, you know, it was weird. I went for the Derby. I fell in love with Louisville. I thought, you know, I'm a city kid. I'm never going to have this opportunity again. I'll stay for a few months.
Mm-hmm.
I'll stay for a year, and with 10 years later, I'm married. I've got two restaurants. I cook all this wonderful food. So,
what have we got on the table here this morning?
So, I have one of my favorite meats. We do a brisket, which we braise with bourbon and some dark spices. I've got a peach glaze on top, which gives it a little sweetness to kind of offset the really dark flavors in there. I love eating this way, where you've got a nice rich meat and surrounded by some lovely accompaniments.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So I have one of our most popular dishes at the restaurant is collards and kimchi,
mm-hmm.
which kind of blends the Southern tradition with the Asian heritage that I grew up with. We also have braised bacon rice. Ginger and bourbon glazed carrots, which is also another favorite at the restaurant.
I like the bourbon theme.
Yeah, I like to use, you know, when in doubt, just reach for a bottle of bourbon.
Mm-hmm.
We've got some cornbread that has a little bit of lardo in it, which basically is the rind of the country ham that we use and chop in there.
Any bourbon in the cornbread?
Not in the cornbread.
But in the cake.
But in the cake.
Oh, good.
Which you have to try. This is a whiskey ginger cake.
Mm-hmm.
And we really try to incorporate different bourbons into different dishes. Depending on the bourbon you use, it adds a smokiness,
mm-hmm.
a sort of a hay flavor, a leather flavor to it. So we really love experimenting with the different bourbons.
And you've actually developed your own bourbon.
Yes, we are. We are developing a bourbon with Jefferson's Reserve.
Mm-hmm.
It's called Collaboration Blend because it's the first time that a chef and a master distiller have gotten together and actually blended a bourbon that is specifically to pair with food.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a very softer, it's a kind of more elegant style bourbon that should be out very shortly.
You graduated magna cum laude from NYU, majoring in literature, right?
Yes,
How'd you end up in cooking?
Thanks for mentioning that.
I was stunned.
You know, as with most English majors out there, it was tough to get a job after graduating. There was not a lot of work out there. And I thought, you know, I cooking has always been my passion. It's
mm-hmm.
always
so it had been there.
It always was what I wanted to do. I tried the publishing thing. I did, you know, the writing thing. And I thought, you know, I'm going to go back and do what I really, really want to do, which is cook. Interestingly enough, 15 years later, I get a book contract, and we decided, you know, finally, all those books I read in college came
back to me. That literature thing is paying off.
It's finally helped me.
And you really, you know, found a way to merge your passions. You write a lot of articles.
Yeah.
This is not your first cookbook. And it's been a very busy year for you, because not only do you have this cookbook coming out, which a lot of people think is one of the best cookbooks of the summer, but you have a new baby.
I do have a new baby, 10 weeks old. Her name's Arden Rose, and she is she's the most delicious thing in my life right now.
What are you looking forward to cooking for her?
Everything. I cannot wait. You know, she's breastfeeding. And so
mm-hmm.
I just look at her and I'm like, I can't wait for you to try this and this, and I want to make all this for you. So
you're feeding your wife right now.
Exactly, exactly, exactly.
So we don't have to ask you who you would have this meal with if you could have it with anyone.
You know, I it's funny. So I talk a lot about my grandmother. I talk about, you know, who's passed on. You know, I talk about my mother. I would love to have my baby girl, as she gets older, sitting there with my grandmother and my mom and my dad, mm-hmm. and just sitting there and having a family meal together.
Or maybe working with you in the kitchen. While we have you sign our dish, which is a tradition, very quickly tell us, you were a huge hit on Top Chef. You said you were very glad you did it, but you don't know that you'd do it again.
I'm old. It's a young man's game. I don't know if this body.
It's intense.
It's very intense. It's a very intense show. It's a great show. But they really put you through the ringer. I mean, it's no joke.
Got it. Well, Chef Edward Lee, thank you so much for being here. And for more on Chef Lee and The Dish, head to our website at cbsnews.com/CBS This Morning.
Plato says oink. Now, don't go away. We'll be right back. You're watching CBS.